Coronation Street's in half an hour after Emmerdale.
And shine, son. What's wrong? Don't you want an education? Come on, Dad. It's time you woke up.
Mum, I'd like to come with you.
I don't think so. Maybe once Len's woken up, got his strength back.
Mum, we're not stupid. He might not wake up, and even if he does, he might have brain damage.
Shut up, Mark.
I was there when the doctor said it.
I don't care. Shut up.
Listen. I don't need aggravation from you two, all right?
Sorry.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
All right.
Mum. Will you ring from the hospital if there's any news?
Yeah, of course I will. Try not to worry, yeah?
Vacuuming?
cooking tea.
Oh, and shopping for it.
What are you doing?
Just getting this rotor sorted. It's the household jobs.
Do we need a rotor? We're not students.
Well, it saves arguing, you see.
Well, let's have a look. I don't think I understand your system. I seem to be doing everything.
Yep, you understand it.
You see, you're the last to move in, so you're actually the first on the rotor.
Right.
But you'll get a turn.
You can cook, can't you?
Yeah, I do a good chilli.
Oh, nice one. Well, we'll see you later.
Oh, and Ed.
Yeah?
The vacuum's in the cupboard under the stairs. Cheers, mate.
What do you want?
What do I always want? You fancy coming back to mine?
I don't know why you're in such a good mood. You could still go down for GBH, Kane.
Can't charge me without evidence, can they?
You seem to think I'm just going to wave a magic wand. If Len recovers, there might not be anything I can do.
You'll think of something. You get the whole thing dropped, and your family and all your bosses find out about us. Now, you're going to do as you're told and make this go away.
I'll do what I can.
Don't worry. I've got complete faith in you. Just convince Len nothing happened.
One of the things I love about you is your impulsive nature.
That's nice.
But I think you've overdone it this time.
No, I don't think so.
Carlos has always seemed to me to be a good cook. There have been no complaints against him, and he's a friend. It's a shame to lose a friendship over a moment's anger.
Carlos may be a decent cook, but he makes too many mistakes. Mistakes mean food gets wasted, and we can't afford that.
But how...
You know your last sermon?
Sorry?
Yeah, well, I thought it dragged a bit in the middle. And if I were you, I'd appoint a new church warden. The current one's lazy.
I see. You don't tell me how to do my job, so I shouldn't tell you how to do yours.
Exactly.
The trouble with that is I take your comments as constructive criticism, and I'll seriously consider them, whereas you refuse to listen to mine.
I have listened to your comments, I have seriously considered them, and I've decided that Carlos is still sacked. The subject matter is closed.
Ah.
Good morning, Eric.
Morning.
What can I get you?
Scotch, please. Ashley.
There you go.
So, Carlos, what happened?
Yes, come on, let's have all the dirt.
What do you mean?
Don't go mysterious on me.
What do you think I mean? Why did Bernice sack you? What did you do?
He didn't do anything. Bernice sacked him because she's a moody cow.
Well, she's always been a moody cow, but she's never sacked him before.
Come on. You must have done something. Were you drunk on duty? No, did you start singing the Spanish national anthem and challenge Ashley to a fight?
Bernice had her reasons.
Well, why don't you come up to the woodpile with me now and try and sort it out?
There's nothing to sort out. She wasn't happy with me. That's all.
Well, sounds a bit weird.
Why are you defending her?
Can we leave it now, please?
Sorry, didn't realise it was so sensitive. Why don't you both come for dinner tonight? I promise I won't talk about it.
I'll see if he's up for it.
All right, see you later.
Do you think he meant to invite me as well? Perhaps he just forgot.
We go now.
Now that Jason has gone, you can tell me what really happened. Don't worry, it won't go any further.
I'll see you outside.
Touchy, isn't he?
There's rather a promising little auction I thought I might attend this afternoon.
Oh? And what does it promise, apart from a tidy profit?
mostly jewellery.
Intriguing.
Yeah, I'll tell you about it this evening, shall I? You don't have any plans, do you?
No, I'll be in.
Good, because there's something important I want to ask you.
Really?
Must dash. I'll see you later.
Pint, please, Jason.
This one's on the house.
Oh, cheers. What do you want?
You might have two more guests tonight, Carlos and Nicola.
You're not exploiting my good nature, are you?
As if. No, I just think Carlos needs cheering up, that's all.
What's your position on the Carlos question?
My position? Mum's told you her position before. She said it was up to me.
That's right. I'm staying out the firing line, Ashley.
Oh, come on. That's not like you. Carlos is a good cook and a hard worker. This makes no sense.
Best let Bernice have her own way when she's in this sort of mood.
All right, fine. Just tell me one thing, then I'll shut up. Who's going to cook for you?
Me. I'm going to do it.
Are you sure?
Why shouldn't she?
No, fine. That should prove very interesting.
Kane.
All right.
Yeah. Been waiting for you.
Looks like you're really angry with me, aren't you?
No, I'm not. It wasn't your fault, it was mine.
Yeah, you talked to the police.
Told him it was an accident.
I knew you would.
It was, wasn't it? An accident.
Of course it was. You saw it. Len came at me, I was just trying to hold him off.
Yeah.
Well, that's what happened, innit?
Hey!
Look, it's best I don't see you for now.
I know.
I'll be thinking about you.
What the hell are you doing here? What did he want?
Nothing.
What are you talking about?
Will you mind your own business?
Are you liking your new job then?
It'll do. Won't mind a look at an engine though.
Oh, well, we'll see how we're going. You all right, Alan?
I've been looking for you. Now, have a look at this. I think this might be just what she wants.
Who are we talking about?
This is the love of Alan's life.
That bike?
Yeah.
Oh, you've seen my Dalesman?
Yeah, it's great.
Well, this is a genuine 1935 spark plug. I got it on the internet.
They haven't changed much, have they?
Well, shall we fit it now?
No, I'm a bit busy this afternoon, Alan. Tomorrow, though, I can fit it for you then.
Right. OK, well, I'll look forward to it.
You're going to do it tomorrow, then?
Yeah, I can't let you help, but Alan won't let anyone unqualified go near that bike. You can watch there for that.
Yeah, thanks.
Dad, can you hear me? Dad, are you all right?
Oh, my head.
Look, don't try and move. I'll get a doctor.
Kane,
what about Kane? Dad, do you remember what happened? Dad, tell me what happened. Dad, what about Kane?
Leave him alone, Sean.
Excuse me.
Can you get a doctor?
Yes, okay.
He mentioned Kane.
Yeah, I know he did. I heard.
You're in hospital. You've had a fall and had a bump on your head.
You on your own?
Just a minute. I seem to be.
Don't mess me about. I'm not in the mood, Jules.
Hey, just chill a bit. What's the problem?
Scott and Turner are going to work on the bike tomorrow. They're going to see what you did. I'm not taking the blame for you, you understand?
Sorry, I'm still not seeing a problem. If the bike was a write-off, or we'd sold it to buy drugs, that would be awkward. As it is, it's just scratched. I pay for the damage, and that's the end of it.
Not good enough.
Why not?
I'm living in a squat. I've come off a council estate. I'm black.
You know what that means to people around here?
What does it mean?
It means they look at me and they think he's trouble. Anything goes wrong in this village, anything gets nicked, broken, anybody gets hurt, they're going to think Danny did it.
Are you sure you're not exaggerating?
What are you doing here?
See what I mean?
What?
Danny was just saying how people pick on him because he thinks they're prejudiced.
No, I'm picking on you because you've got no business here. Unless you happen to own a thoroughbred horse. No, I didn't think so. And I'm picking on you because it looks like you've hardly started that filing. You're not getting out of here till it's done, get me?
You better sort it, Jules.
Yeah, whatever. All right. I'm filing.
I should ring that sergeant. Tell him what Dad said.
There's no point, Sean. They already know Kane was in the house.
Well, if he was in the house, he was burgling it. I mean, why else would he be there?
Just calm down.
My dad found him. Kane kicked him down the stairs and ran for it. He left him for dead.
Stop it, Sean. This isn't helping.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, as soon as they let us talk to Dad, we'll find out what happened. Then, as soon as he's confirmed it, they'll arrest Kane, won't they?
Depending on what Len says.
You know what he's going to say. Look, don't worry, love. Kane's going to spend the next few years inside.
Do you think Ed's going to do all those jobs?
Hey, I think we want to win it, eh, you know? He's too soft to argue about it.
Oh, yeah, I asked Nicola and Carlos to come for dinner tonight.
Yeah, the more the merrier. As long as I'm not cooking.
Well, I don't know about Mary. They're not in the best of moods. But, you know, let's go and see how Ed's cracking on.
Yeah.
I don't want to discuss Carlos.
I don't care what you want. You can't just sack him because you're in a bad mood.
Nicola, I think he should leave.
I'm not finished. But this is his livelihood we're talking about. He's unemployed thanks to you.
That's not my responsibility.
Someone sending the food back?
What's the problem?
The sauce was a bit lumpy and cold.
You can't come up with one good reason for sacking him. The customers aren't happy and you don't look happy. Well, just swallow your pride and have him back.
Nicola, will you please just go away?
Why should I?
Just go.
Take this to the kitchen, would you, pet, and put some pizzas in the oven. Go on, love.
What is her problem?
Right now it's you. I think you'd better make yourself scarce.
Please go gently. He's very weak. Try not to strain him.
Dad, how are you feeling?
Terrible.
I thought we'd lost you.
You know me. Tough as our boats.
It's good to have you back, then.
We'd like to carry out some tests on your father.
What sort of test?
We want to be sure he's made a full recovery.
Why don't you go and have a chat with the doctor? I'll stay here with Len.
But
go on. Don't think Len's going anywhere. Come on, Sean. You heard what the doctor said. He needs rest. Don't start interrogating him now.
Okay. Hey, Dad. Take it easy. Keep your hands off those nurses.
You must be tired, Len.
Yeah, I'm a bit.
Only I need to talk to you about what happened. I need to talk to you about Kane.
This was a good idea. What's the occasion?
It's not your birthday, is it?
I just had an inkling a small celebration might be in order.
Did you?
To us.
To us. Actually, I did have a good time in the auctions, it happens.
Did you, find what you were looking for?
I'll tell you in a moment. First of all, Gloria, I want you to know how deeply I respect you.
Your feelings are reciprocated.
We were perhaps, thrown together in a rather surprising way, but most successful partnerships can have unlikely beginnings.
Yes, we are a successful partnership, I feel that too.
Which is why I've decided to take a step which, frankly, may seem a little impetuous, sir. Come as a surprise.
A welcome one, I assure you.
Enough preamble.
Open it up.
Come.
30,000 there. It came to me after I had lunch with that accountant. He recommended an investment account, and I decided, for tax reasons, I'd put it in somebody else's name. I'd like you to be that person.
So she goes, that's not my responsibility, and Diane tells me I better make myself scarce.
Hey, Nick, should we change the subject now?
Yeah, good idea.
This might be a bit much for me. Should we swap?
No point. All the portions are just the same. This is excellent.
I think you should stay on cooking, Julia. Yeah.
All the vegetables are homegrown, of course, including the chilies.
Smatter, don't you like spicy food?
Oh. I'm sorry, I don't think I can eat that. Does everyone think it's all right?
Mm. Great.
Yeah.
You wimp. How about you, Scott?
Hang on. Excuse me. There's extra chilies in ours, isn't there?
These two seem to think I was going to be some sort of domestic servant. I thought I'd better put them straight.
You got an Nazi streak in you, haven't you?
Maybe you should sabotage the food at the Woolly.
There's no need. Diane's doing the cooking. I reckon they're going to come crawling back to you in no time.
You went to sleep again.
Did I?
How are you feeling now?
So-so. She said something about Kane.
Do you remember what happened?
He's coming back. It was Ollie.
Yeah. Kane was visiting Ollie. He wanted to borrow a CD, apparently.
It was more than that.
How do you know?
They were on the bay. I could tell Kane was trying it on.
Well, what about the fall?
All. I was trying to help Ollie, protect her. Kane Dingle pushed me down the stairs.
He remembered everything.
It's hazy, but I'll be able to tell the police what happened.
I don't want you to, Len.
What?
I want you to lie to the police.
Don't worry. I'll cook up something special tomorrow. We'll manage. I don't know if I will. It's hard now, but it's for the best.
It's such a mess, Mum. I don't know what to think anymore. I mean, suddenly he just turned around and said it was over. Why did he do that? Does he hate me?
Oh, no, Petty doesn't hate you.
Why then? It doesn't make any sense.
I can't bear seeing you like this. I had a word with him.
You what?
But I didn't say anything he wasn't already thinking.
You warned him off, didn't you?
Not exactly.
You told him to end it. You come in here with your hugs and your sympathy, but it's all your fault.
Bernice!
No, I don't want to hear it. Just go.
I'll save a great deal on tax. The business will benefit. It's a win-win situation. You can see us going from strength to strength.
By us, you mean?
I mean the business. Which includes you, of course. Shall we have another toast?
No, I don't think so.
You doing all right?
No, not really. I think I'll go home.
We haven't had the main course yet.
You eat it, Eric. After all, you are used to eating on your own. I expect in some ways you prefer it.
I just told him if you two want to be together, you should come out into the open instead of lying to everyone.
I was happy, Mum.
What's the matter with you? Couldn't you cope with that?
What do you think was going to happen between you and Carlos?
I've got no idea. And you know what? I don't care. All my life, I've been careful, tried to think ahead, to be good. And just this once, I dived in without a moment's thought. And you know what? I was having a ball until you stuck your nose in.
I just want what's best for you. You know I do.
Same as you did when you kept my dad out of my life.
That's got nothing to do with this.
That was about you manipulating my life, and this is exactly the same.
No, it isn't. You were being cruel to Ashley and Nicola. And you lied to me.
That's what really bothers you, isn't it?
That I lied to you, that I kept you out the loop, and you can't stand that, can you? Fine, you just do what you want. Don't come crawling back to me when it all goes wrong.
Oh, get out.
Go on, just get out and leave me alone.
I don't know what's happened to you.
Something's turned bitter inside you.
I'm going. And I wish you luck, because from this moment on, I'm having nothing to do with you. You're on your own.
So what are you saying? Are you going to let him get away with what he did to Ollie?
Something you should know.
Go on.
Cain didn't force himself on Ollie. It's what she wanted now. That is the truth. And that's what's going to come out in court. It'll probably be in the papers.
I can't understand this.
Well, then think about Sean. If he knows that Cain had sex with Ollie and then pushed you down the stairs, he's going to either kill Cain or get himself killed trying.
But I can't just let this go.
I want you to tell the police that you just fell down the stairs, that you were arguing with Cain, but there was no physical contact.
He took advantage of Ollie and he tried to kill me. He deserves to go to jail.
Please, Len, I need you to do this for me.
I can't, and I don't know why you're asking me to.
You don't know the whole story.
What are you talking about?
Cain was only with Ollie because he was trying to get back at me.
But get back at you for what?
I had an affair with him. I ended it, but... well, he just couldn't cope.
What?
That's what all this is about. He was stalking me. He tried to kill me, Len, and now he started using Ollie.
He tried to kill you?
Yeah, it's been a nightmare. Look, I don't know what to do, Len. I need your help.
Oh, dear God. I don't believe this.
If he goes to prison, then Cain is going to tell Sean and Ollie about the affair. They'll destroy the family, Len.
I don't know what to say.
I need you to tell the police that it wasn't Cain's fault.
The doctor's really happy with your progress, Dad.
Len?
I want you both to go home. Now.
Are you all right?
I just need some rest.
Well, you keep your strength up. The police will be in to see you tomorrow.
Yeah, I know they will.
David Jason, Pam Ferris and Catherine Zeta-Jones.
Incredible.
Classic British television, The Darling Buds of May, tonight 8:30.
In a moment, Roy and Haley take drastic action on Coronation Street. And later at 9:30, you can see the concluding part of our drama, The Russian Bride.